step into the realm of creativity with me as I embark on a fascinating journey of designing the mail app UI using the incredible capabilities of ChatGPT. In this video, I navigate through the intricacies of crafting a sleek and user-friendly mail app interface. Whether you're a design enthusiast or simply curious about the potential of AI in UI design, this video provides an engaging exploration into possibilities that arise when human imagination meets the power of language models. Join me on this unique adventure and let's see what ChatGPT is capable of. Let's find out if we can build this UI with the help of ChatGPT. Now, I will try not to interfere as much as possible. I have started a brand new ChatGPT mail app. And let's just open up ChatGPT right over here. And let's start typing. And let's take a look at what we actually want to achieve. Well, we want to have some sort of a sectioned list in Swift UI with some icons and navigation with some text and maybe some numbers of what the navigation will have. Also, I want the navigation title over here, an edit button, and also some updated just now text over at the bottom, and maybe a new create a new mail button right over here. So let's see what we can do with ChatGPT. At rebeloper.com/mentoring, I am delighted to extend an invitation to explore my mentoring services, tailored to guide and empower individuals on their journey in software development. As a mentor, my mission is to provide personalized one-on-one guidance to help you navigate the intricacies of coding, app development, and software architecture. Visit rebeloper.com/mentoring to discover a comprehensive mentoring experience aimed at accelerating your growth and success in the dynamic world of software development. Let's just add in here. Okay, let's see what we got here. Okay, it says, I can help you with Swift UI code. Please describe the design or let me know what specific functionality you are looking for. Now, do my best to assist you by providing the corresponding Swift UI code. Now, this may go wrong all the way. Let's see. Okay. Let's see what's giving us. Okay, and the good thing that I like is that also explaining what the code does. Okay, let's copy the code out actually, and let's put this into our Xcode project. So let's see right over here. Let's paste it. Yeah, it imported also Swift UI, really nice. And now let's build and run iPhone 15, and let's see. Till that point, till this launches, I'm going to take a look at this code. So we have a section 1, 1, 2, 4. Yeah, it looks like it is actually adding some really, really good code right over here. We have the list style, group list style. I don't know if that is the one that I want, sections list. Let me just go to our preview. And yeah, it looks really, really nice. Now, let's try some other stuff. Let's remove the actual group list style. So let's go back to ChatGPT. Remove the group list style. And let's see what else. And set the navigation title to mailboxes. Okay, let's copy this out and let's see how it looks like. So I will select A, Command V to paste it in there, and let's build and run again. So it looks really, really nice. Mailboxes, as you can see. Now what we want to do, and it looks really, really amazing, what we want to do is remove the section titles also. Oh, this is going much better than I expected. Oh, really, really nice. So it removed the sections. So let's copy this code. Maybe I did not formulate that clearly. So let's paste it. So now we have only one section, but without the title. So I think we removed the whole section. Let's rephrase this. Well, we have the edit button, which is really, really nice. We have the mailboxes. Now let's continue. Okay, let's see. So we have this section. Really, really nice. Okay, so it added the list style. Apply list style if desired. Well, I don't want that. Remove the list style, please. Okay, so it's the same code with the list style. Really, really nice. Let's copy this out. Let's copy code and then let's paste it into Xcode. Again, Command A and Command V to paste that, and let's build and run one more time. Ooh, really close. Let's see. We have the preview right over here. Okay, so let's not mess this up. Let's have also a toolbar item at the low, at the trailer, at the bottom of our view. Let's see if we can add that. Let's see this button to create a new mail. Let's go. There we go. Square and pencil. Okay, let's see. Here we go. We have those two sections. We have the navigation title. And here we go. Let's see if this code, it looks like it's okay. Let's copy it out. There we go. We have our square dot and pencil icon. Really, really nice. Okay, so it's at the bottom bar. Let's see if I can tweak this. Let's see if this would be quite amazing. Okay, well, let's see. Okay, so we have a spacer. Let's see if it's that's going to do it. Let's copy out the code. Let me just double check. Here we go with the spacer. Maybe we do need a vertical, a horizontal stack over there. No, it's amazing. Okay, so now let's add the updated just now text to the bottom bar. Okay, let's see how it's going to handle this. Okay, we have our sections again. Okay, let's see what we got. Let's copy out the code and paste it in, like replace that. It should be okay. Let's see. There we go. Updated just now. Now, I don't think that this is fully centered, but it will work for now. I'm not going to tweak this for now. It's really, really nice. And it says the font, foreground color, secondary. I did not say that it should be foreground color, secondary, but it added that, which I really, really like. Now, let's take a look at the original one and let's see what do we need to do right over here. So, first of all, let's make all of the section items, like the cells, a navigation link because now, well, they are navigation links. Really great. Okay, so let's double check if they just navigate. I just did not realize that they are actually navigation links. Let's go over there. Yeah, it's working really nice. So let's try to change. Let's add some icons. Let's have some folder icons and to let's add all of them. Well, what I'm going to do is add default, like dummy icons. Let's see. I think I made myself clear, but I'm not sure. Let's see. Indeed, it did the trick. Really, really nice. Okay, let's copy out the code and paste it in to Xcode. And let's build and run. This is amazing. Okay, so it added the mail. Really, really nice. Okay, so now let's change the elements numbers. Let's have on the first section 3 and on the second one 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so. Okay, looks like it did it. Let's copy out the code. This is going amazing. There we go. Okay, now what should we do? Well, I would like to add a section header to the second section, but that should be an expandable section. Okay, now let's see if that can be done by ChatGPT. Okay, so it added actually, let's see, a disclosure group. Let's see. Copy out the code. I don't think this will be perfect, but let's see. Let's build and run because I have the header as the Gmail disclosure group, expandable section. Okay, it's not quite what I expected, but let's leave it as is because I think it will just mess things up more if I just change this. Because it is an expandable section. Great. Let's say that this will be kind of the thing that ChatGPT could not make. Most probably I could tweak this, but I don't know how to do the tweak efficiently, so I would just leave it as is. Now let's try to change some of the navigation link icons. So what I want this to be, let's set the first navigation link title to be an inbox, and let's set the actual inbox. I believe that's inbox. Let me just see the name, the title. Let's see, inbox. It's called tray. Okay. Let's see how it is going to handle this. Okay, I'm really curious. Okay, so what it did, I believe it changed all of them. Let's copy out the code. Let's put it into Xcode, paste it in there. You see tray and inbox. Okay, adjust color is needed. Okay, foreground color blue, that's fine. Inbox, we have these. Not bad, not bad, but still, yeah, and because it's just going for the for each, that's why it does that. Let's see if it's going to change this to, let's say, draft, and I believe this is doc, drafts and doc. Okay, so let's go to Safari, drafts. Okay, let's see that. Okay, so we have that inbox, and then, well, let's just copy it out. I think it did the trick. Let's copy that code out. Okay. Paste it in there. Let's see. It did do the trick right over here because now it's the first one. Otherwise, it's going to be an envelope. Right. Okay, so yeah, the text, drafts, item for the index, really nice. So it's getting the hang of it. Let's try to do the second one. It's going to be sent, and let's see what the SF symbol send. Paper plane. Okay. Let's see. Oh, it's doing an if else statement. Really, really nice. Copy code. Command A, Command V. Let's build and run. There we go, really, really nice. Now, I would like to see this inside the switch statement. Okay, let's see if it can handle that. Statement. Oh, this would be so amazing if it could do this. Let's see. Switch case to default value. Really, really nice. I'm actually blown away. This is really, really great. Let's copy out the code. Let's paste it in there. We have dark paper print. Really, really nice. Okay, so what else should we do? I'm really, really liking this approach. Okay, so maybe one final thing. Yes, let's try to add the numbers. Let's see if we can add that. And we would do that. Let's try on the inbox. So let's try to add this number to that cell. Okay, so let's see. I know it's a lot of explanation over there, but let's see if it could do that. And I believe it did. Let's see. If it did, then I would just call it a wrap. And let's see, where is my copy code? There we go. There we go. It added all of them. Of course, it set up the secondary color to the inbox also, but that is just fine. So let's take a look at the original, what I was intending to do. And with a few prompts, we just got this, which is actually amazing. You just need to actually tweak this, which is really, really great. Now, if you did like this video and you were also thinking about switching the if-else statement into a switch statement, make sure to check out this video right over here, which is about if-else or switch.